This is what Arsenal fans deserve. Yeah. Not just in terms of the scoreline, but the performance, the willingness to run, mm-hmm. to tackle. They were feeding off the crowd's energy. They understood the assignment.
That's right.
They understood the assignments. They knew that we didn't start well. We've got two narrow wins. This is an opportunity to kickstart our season. Arteta got it right. Brilliant team selection. I love the attacking pattern of the team. Mm-hmm. He made use of his strongest assets in terms of in going forward. Odegaard, Saka, Smith Rowe. The way they were switching it up, making it very difficult for Tottenham to pick them up. And look, Aubameyang has come alive at the right time. He also understood the assignment, dropping deep, linking up, and his pace is devastating. It looks like he's growing old, but that aspect of his game is not going down. He's very, very quick. If you watch his goal, when he flicked it, you look at the amount of time he used to quickly recover and get back into position. That is the hunger of a striker you want to see. The fact that he feels he started a move, but he wants to get at the end of that move and put the ball in the back of the net. And as I said at the beginning, this is what Arsenal fans deserve. For Tottenham Hotspur, I'm not surprised. They started the season 1-0, 1-0, 1-0.
And what manager of the...
Look, honestly speaking, with Nuno, he reminds me of Poch. I don't think it is... It doesn't make sense to me to hype up a manager when the person doesn't have tangibles. Do you get me? You don't impress me by taking a team and finishing sixth if you want to be Tottenham Hotspur coach and be winning trophies. If you want to be managing Aston Villa and finishing in top half of the season, fine, I'll give you your credit. But for Nuno to come into the job and for talk after three matches of him being the guy to bring... No, I did my top eight in the season and I didn't add these two teams. I still feel Arsenal will finish outside the top eight. But honestly speaking, I feel like they should. This is a sort of performance that they should be giving the fans. You might be confused in terms of tactics, but body language and your look, motivation should always be high. Once fans are in the stadium, once they are there, once they are watching you, you have to give it everything. And that is something I saw in the Norwich game. Even when they were not scoring goals, remember I said it, they looked frustrated, but they were bent on getting the ball in the back of the net, and they did it. The Burnley game, they understood the assignment. They scored. They knew the threat of Burnley, so they sat back, protected their lead. And again today, what just pained me was the fact that Tottenham got a goal, because they didn't deserve a goal in this game.
Right.
Arsenal were very good and solid in terms of defense, and it was a sloppy goal to give away to Son Heung-min. But look, credit to Arsenal, credit to the attacking four of Saka, Odegaard, Smith Rowe, and Aubameyang. I feel this is a sort of performance where Mikel Arteta should sit back, look at it, and
that's
maintain
the
them. Look, it's worked. If you are going to bring in anybody who deserves to come into this game, maybe on the basis of the last two performances, Pepe comes in. But this is why you are a top team, for you to have that headache in terms of selection.
Yeah.
But not tinker with the team, and today this guy is out completely, and you don't know why he's playing. This was a good game for Arsenal. And funny enough, now they are level on points with Tottenham, and they've overtaken them.